In this screencast, we're going to look at a combustion reaction and solve for not only the amounts of components in the product gas, but also the dew point temperature of the product or stack gas. Generally, the only condensable species in the stack gas is water. So to find the dew point temperature, we're going to use Raoult's law that says the partial pressure of water is equal to the saturated pressure of water at the dew point temperature. So in order to apply this equation, what we're going to need to find is that mole fraction of water. So in this problem, we have 10 moles of ethane, and it's going to be combusted with 40% excess air. And so what that means is that we'll not only have O2 in our product gas, we'll also have N2. In addition, the fractional conversion of ethane is 0.75, which means that we'll have ethane in our product gas. And finally, the selectivity of the desired product, which is CO2, versus the undesired product, which is CO, is going to equal 5. So this means that we have incomplete combustion occurring as well. So let's start with a flowchart of our process. We'll start by figuring out how much oxygen and therefore nitrogen comes into our system. So we're told that there is 40% excess oxygen. In order to be able to solve for that, we have to write the combustion reaction. So we have C2H6, which reacts with 7/2 moles of O2, and that gives us 2 moles of CO2 plus 3 moles of H2O. Note that I haven't written the incomplete combustion reaction, as excess oxygen is always based on the desired reaction. So for every mole of ethane, we're going to need 3.5 moles of oxygen. So if we have 10 moles of ethane, we multiply it by 3.5, that would give us our theoretical amount of oxygen. However, since we have 40% excess, we multiply this by 1.4, and we end up with 49 moles of oxygen coming in. From that, we can find the number of moles of our N2 coming in. Since the relationship is 3.76 times the number of moles of O2 equal the number of moles of N2. And this is equal, therefore, to 184 moles. It's very important in these combustion reactions not to forget the nitrogen, because the composition of your product stream is going to be completely wrong. So the next thing that we're going to do is use the fractional conversion to find the amount of ethane that's coming out. So we know that 0.75 is equal to the number of moles of ethane coming in minus the number of moles of ethane coming out divided by the number of moles of ethane coming in. And this allows us to solve for the number of moles of ethane coming out, which is equal to 2.5 moles. So the next thing we're going to do is use our atomic species balances to solve for the rest of our components. We're going to start with our carbon balance. So we have 10 moles of ethane coming in, and for every mole of ethane, we have 2 atoms of carbon, and that's going to equal the moles of ethane coming out times those two carbon atoms plus the number of moles of CO coming out plus the number of moles of CO2 coming out. Each of them has one carbon atom per mole. But if you recall from our selectivity, the number of moles of CO2 equal 5 times the number of moles of CO. So we can replace that NCO2 with 5 times NCO. That allows us to solve for the number of moles of carbon monoxide, which is 2.5 moles. And then to solve for the number of moles of CO2, we just multiply that by 5 and get the number of moles of CO2 equaling 12.5. The next balance I'm going to do is the hydrogen balance. In a combustion reaction, I always save the oxygen balance for last because oxygen is in so many of the components in a combustion reaction. So for our hydrogen, we have our 10 moles of ethane coming in, and there are 6 hydrogen atoms in 1 mole of ethane. And now this is again going to equal 2.5 times our 6, plus, now there are 2 atoms of hydrogen in every mole of H2O. We can solve for the number of moles of H2O, which is equal to 22.5 moles. And finally, we do our oxygen balance. So coming in, we have the number of moles of oxygen. There are 2 oxygen atoms in every mole of O2. And this is going to equal the 22.5 moles from the H2O plus the 2.5 moles from the CO plus 2 times the 12.5 moles from the CO2, since there are 2 oxygen atoms, plus 2 times the number of moles of O2 coming out. And so what we're left with is that the number of moles of O2 that are coming out are equal to 24 moles. And since nitrogen is not a reactive species, the number of moles of N2 equal the number of moles that came in. Since we're looking for the mole fraction of water, we're going to have to find the total moles. So we're going to have to add up all the products in our stat gas. So when we add this all up, we get a total of 248 moles. And look at the difference we would have gotten if we hadn't included nitrogen, which is a substantial amount of the moles in the product gas. The definition of a mole fraction is the number of moles of H2O, and I'm going to call this YH2O. So this is going to equal our 22.5 moles divided by our 248 moles. And so our mole fraction of water is 0.09. Now we can find the partial pressure of water. So our Y times our pressure is equal to 0.09 times our 2 atmospheres, which is our pressure, times 760 millimeters of mercury per atmosphere, because generally the tables that are used for saturation pressures are given in millimeters of mercury. And this is going to equal 137.7 millimeters of mercury. So when we go to a table of vapor pressures of water as a function of temperature and look up the saturated or vapor pressure, we find that the dew point temperature, or the temperature that goes with this saturation pressure, is equal to 58.2 degrees Celsius.